why do you want to see Bobby all of a sudden? We thought he upset you.
Well, I really like him. I always have.
I will let you fall. Don't you trust me?
Yeah!
Honey, you bet it's gross and it's disgusting, but it's beer, son.
It's beer, huh?
You're not taking Nolie out of my house. He's still my child.
Please try to understand. Noel's not being forced to do anything.
I said we're gonna play golf.
Are you sure he's okay?
What?
Yeah, he's all right.
I don't know.
Bob may move, it's okay.
Help me.
When he walked in here.
Charlie, come on.
Come on, nothing. This guy's having a coronary attack. I've seen it on TV. I've seen it on the news.
No.
Come on.
I'm going to call the cops.
Look at my...
Yeah.
My daddy.
What is it, Nolie?
It's a card. Okay. Got money in there. Hey, look, everybody. 21. This is how old I am.
Yeah. See, today I am a man.
I've been. Where have you been?
I've been chaperoning for Bobby with my birthday money.
Oh. Oh, well, that's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah.
May I take a peek?
Yeah.
Oh, that's all right. Don't worry about it. We'll fix it later. Just tell me what it is.
Oh, it's a golf cap. But when Bobby plays golf, he'll need a golf cap.
No, wait, sit down. What? Sit down. I want you to listen to me as carefully as you can.
Okay.
Now, button up the lips.
Oh.
Put on the listening ears. Oh. Okay? Now, Bobby has been gone a very long time. I want you to try to understand that he's a very old man. He's a very sick man.
81.
Yes, and that's very old.
Yeah. Mr. Seidel, he's 81. He still runs the soda.
Well, I know, but Mr. Seidel is not sick, and no. Bobby is. I just don't want you to be upset, that's all.
All right. But Bobby will still play golf, won't he? Bobby always loves to play golf.
No, Nolie. Bobby's too weak to play golf anymore. Now it's 4:00, time to take your pill.
Oh. No, I don't want to take your pill no more.
Anymore. Of course you want to. Why don't you want to take the pills?
I don't wanna.
Nolie, why not?
Oh, they make me sad.
They don't make you sad, they calm you down. Don't you remember how upset
no,
you
I
used
don't
to
want
get?
I don't
wanna. Nolie, Dr. Lathrop would be very cross with you. Now come on. Come on. Come on. Here, open up. There you go. Down the hatch. That's a good boy. Let me see. Good boy. Very good.
Okay.
Now you can have some cookies.
Good, okay.
Okay, go clean up.
Okay.
Come on, go clean up.
All right.
We're gonna leave as soon as Daddy gets back.
When will we get there? Yeah. He wanted to be with the nurses.
Well.
When will we get
there? No, honey. I couldn't take care of both you and Bobby.
When Nana died in Florida, and Bobby got sick and couldn't take care of himself, old people get that way sometimes. Uh-huh.
Just like babies.
Oh.
Nolie, listen to me.
Yeah.
Listen to me.
Okay.
You may not recognize Bobby right now.
What? Right now?
You may not know him right away.
No.
Because listen to me.
No, what?
He's aged a lot in 2 years.
No.
He got a lot older in 2 years.
No, I know Bobby.
All right, darling. Sit down.
Are we there yet?
No, we'll be there in a little while. Sit down.
All right. When will we get there? When will we get there? When will we get there? When will we get there?
Where's Bobby?
Oh, where's Bobby? Where's Bobby?
Nolie.
What?
May I help you?
Yeah.
We're here to see my father last night.
Bobby.
Oh, it's this way.
Oh, okay.
Nolie.
What? Hey, Bobby.
Hey, Bobby. That singing would drive me crazy. Where's Bobby?
Hi, Bobby. It's me, Nolie. I couldn't visit you in Florida when you went. When you left me. Bobby, how come he can't hear me?
Bobby, hi.
Well, you look just great, Bobby. Does Nolie look great, too?
Bobby's really not much of a talker. I'm afraid we haven't heard a word from him in the 2 weeks he's been here. Well, I'll be in the lobby if you need me.
Thank you.
How are you doing, Pop?
Okay.
Not a bad place here, huh? Takes a little getting used to, right? Everything takes getting used to, right, Pop? You know what Nolie said coming down? He said you like to come here because of the nurses. I figured that's something you'd say.
Well, Mr. Miner, you have visitors. How nice. This must be your son and his wife.
Oh, yes. This is Frank Miner, and I'm Dottie Miner.
Oh.
This is our son, Nolie.
Hi.
Hello.
Well, how nice. Let's show your children how well you take your medicine. There's the pill.
Now, you see how Bobby takes his medicine? Just like you. And he doesn't complain.
There you go. Good.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
What?
I gotta go to the bathroom.
It's right there, right behind you.
Oh, thank you.
Where's the bathroom?
Right here. It's right here. Here.
Oh.
You all right?
I'm all right. Close the door.
I'm closing the door. I thought he looked just great tonight. How about you?
Yeah.
There you are. Hurry, hurry. You'll be late for school.
It's not called school. It's called workshop.
Oh.
They teach you how to live in a competitive world.
Yeah, well, what's the matter with our world? Now, come on. Come on now, man. You've got to eat your breakfast.
I don't want no breakfast.
Any breakfast. Any breakfast. What are you talking about? You don't want any breakfast.
I'm not hungry.
Oh, of course you're hungry. You have to eat. Breakfast is the most nutritious
meal. Oh, yeah, I'm not hungry, Mom.
What is it, Nolie? What's the matter? I think I know. It was yesterday, wasn't it? I know how sad it is to see Bobby like that. I wish there was something we could do for him. There isn't. Hey, hey. I almost forgot. I have a surprise for you. Look, look. It's a Star Wars lunchbox. Isn't that great? See, has all your favorite characters on it. You'll be the envy of school. Come on, there's the bus.
You just have to drink the milk for breakfast and have water for lunch. Come on, move it, move it.
And just because he's nice enough to honk doesn't mean he's gonna wait. Go.
Here he comes. Here he comes. Good morning. Bye, Nolie.
Hello, Irene.
Forget it, Irene.
Good. Tell me how you're doing.
Okay.
Morning, Noel. Did you have a good weekend?
No.
No.
That's a good one. That's a good one. No, that's a good one.
All right,
one,
that's
no.
enough, Tommy. Here are your supplies. Now, don't forget, you have classes at 10 and 1:30, so you have to work hard to make up for that time, okay?
That was a good one, Noel.
Because this is a class in independent living skills, we need to learn about style, the way we dress and choosing our own clothes, okay? Now, I'm going to go around the room and ask everybody to tell me who buys their clothes. Berta? Come on.
My mother!
Barry, when would you wear a coat and a tie?
Snorkeling!
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 Congregation?
Congregation, that's true. Barry, would you wear a coat and a tie to a football game?
Oh, no.
Why not?
No.
You might.
Why not?
You might wear a coat and tie to a football
yeah.
game.
Yeah, you might.
That's not right. Most people don't, and really, we probably shouldn't. Noel? Noel.
What? Oh, football game. Yeah, you wear a uniform.
You do wear a uniform, okay. Players wear uniforms.
Nolie? Did everybody like your new lunchbox today? I got him a really neat Star Wars lunchbox.
Great.
Yeah. I'm done. Excuse me.
Wait a minute. What about dessert? I made your favorite, cherry jello.
Finish your plate, Nolie.
I don't want any. Excuse me.
Nolie's group counselor called today. He wanted to know if Nolie was ill. I told him about our visit to Boppy.
Why?
Because I happen to think that's really the problem. Nolie's always been the center of Bobby's attention.
Well, people get old.
Well, I wish you'd try telling Nolie that. I have.
He's got to learn about life sooner or later. The real world's not like that coddling school you got him in. Star Wars lunchboxes.
That coddling school, as you call it, may be Nolie's only chance for a real life. I don't see how you can begrudge him that.
Begrudge him? I'm paying for it, aren't I? I pay enough money.
Besides, he happens to like Star Wars.
Great. Does he have to wear it like a child? And that Mickey Mouse birthday party you give him.
Adults.
Acting like a bunch of screaming children. I mean, the boy is 21 years old, Dot.
You still call him a boy.
Yeah. Well, what Nolie needs is for us to send him back to Bobby this weekend.
I don't think that's a good idea.
It's a good idea. It's like a rider falling off a horse. You put him right back on again.
Yes, she can. Come on, now, let's move it.
No. I'm sick.
All right, where's your note?
I forgot it.
Let me tell you something, Noel. Your body's like a muscle. You exercise it, it gets strong and hard. You don't exercise it, it gets weak and flabby like an old man. Now, you know that. What's the matter with you? All right, stop eating that crap. Look at yourself. Go on. Look at the shape you're in. Yesterday, you told me that you were sick. I found out from your mother that wasn't a problem. That's not being very straight now, is it? Look at me, Noel. Everyone grows old, everyone. But not everyone has to grow weak and sick like your grandfather. And most of those that do, they've stopped exercising their minds and their bodies. Look, I don't know your grandfather. Maybe that's not his problem, but it's your problem. You're getting to be an old man, like your grandfather.
Who is my best friend?
Yeah. Come on, let's go. Look, you know why I'm making you do this?
No.
because I like you. I always have. If you care about someone, you try and help them.
Oh. Okay, I gotta get my desk closed.
No time for that today. You have these, all right? Special privileges.
Oh.
All right, come on, everybody. Let's continue dancing. Come on. Let's go.
What?
I said, I'm really glad you're dancing, Nolie.
You are?
Uh-huh.
Here's the butter, Bobby.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Nolie.
What?
You smell terrible.
Oh.
Didn't you shower after dance class today?
I had special privileges.
That's a privilege. What? Smell like a football team?
Catch the ball, please.
Yeah. Nolie, on Saturday, we got to go see my dad again. Why don't you go with us?
Oh, I can't go.
Why not?
Barry Duncan's birthday party.
Oh, you're absolutely right, Nolie. He's right, dear. He can't go on Saturday.
Can I go Sunday?
Sunday?
Yeah, I go Sunday.
Well, as a matter of fact, your father and I do have to go and see the bailiff.
Oh, I'll ride my bike.
It's very far.
I've been that far before. Dave Daly's birthday party. And it's not busy roads.
That's right, it's not busy at all.
Well, yeah. Nolie, I'm very confused. Why do you want to see Bobby all of a sudden? I thought he upset you so.
Oh, yeah. Well, he did. But, well, I really like him. I always have.
Well, your father and I will have to talk about it.
What's to talk? He wants to do something on his own, let him go.
Yeah.
Frank?
What? Frank. What's the problem here? There's no problem. We got no problems here. We got no damn problems. We got no problems. We got beer. That's what we got. We got beer. We're going to toast Nolie.
Oh.
Birthday boy, huh?
Yeah.
Birthday boy. No, birthday man.
Oh, Frank, don't let him drink too much.
Oh, what? He never drank before?
No.
You had on your party the other day instead of them fizzies or Kool-Aid or whatever it was, huh?
Yeah.
All right, here's to Nolie.
Mine won't open.
Oh, here, let me get it for you.
Oh.
Oh, sorry.
Oh.
Sorry.
Oh,
sorry.
No. Oh.
Sorry. No.
Oh, okay.
Oh!
Oh!
You drink it with two hands now, huh?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
All right, so be it.
All right.
Today, you are a man.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Yuck.
Oh, that's gross.
You bet it's gross. It's disgusting, but it's beer, son. It's beer.
Beer, huh?
Yeah. It's beer, man.
Yeah.
Hi, Bobby. It's me, Nolie. So, what's new? How are you today? Rode my bike alone all the way. It's very far. It's funny. Oh. Oh.
No. Oh, you shouldn't take all the pills they give you. Oh, they'll make you sad. Like me. I read a book about it once. Okay, I saw a book. You know what I do? It's a secret. I hide them in my cheeks so they think I took them. Then they can't tell. You want to see? I'll show you, okay? Yeah. Oh, yes. Okay, you have to look carefully. Candy. Can't pretend. Okay. She says open up. I open up. You can go with the pill. And then, with my tongue, I hide the pill in my cheek, in between my cheek and my lip, before she gives me the water. And then she gives me the water, she said, down the hatch, and I drink. Yeah, and that's it. See? You can't see no pill in my mouth. Huh? Yeah. Oh, but when she's gone, abracadabra. I usually stick the pill in the plant. Now the plant looks real sad. Oh, I got you a gift. Yeah, only I forgot to give it to you. Okay. Well, okay. I didn't forget to give it to you. It's just that, well, you're not really Bobby anymore. Yeah. See, inside, it's a golf cap for when you play golf. See, and I thought that, well, I could drive a cart like before. But, well, you're so weak. And you're so... I told Barry Duncan you were dead. And then Mr. Phelps, he told me that if I didn't exercise, I'd get like you. What's the matter, Bobby? Huh? Didn't you have no one to play with when you were in Florida? I had to play with you. I play with you now.
Good morning, Mr. Miner. Oh, are you having a nice chat? I'm sure you are. Here you go. Perk you up a little. He's not much of a conversationalist, is he? Well, he may talk a little after this pill takes effect. The doctor just started him on these yesterday, so we'll see. Good. Here you go. Good. Okay, Mr. Miner, I'll see you in a couple of hours. You have a nice visit.
I don't understand you. Got no plan?
No plans.
You look great, Bobby.
Crap.
Bobby.
I can see a little. I can hear. Damn hymns.
Well, how come you pretend?
Nolie.
Yeah?
Come here.
Yeah? What is it?
Secret.
A secret? What's a secret?
Me.
Yeah. How come?
It's easier.
Oh.
Promise me.
Yeah, okay.
Again.
Oh, I promise.
Goodbye, Nolie.
Goodbye? No. No. Well, we didn't do exercises. And if you don't do your exercises, you won't get strong, like Mr. Phelps, our dance teacher. Bobby, that's why I came today. Mr. Phelps said that if you don't exercise, you get weak and run down. All we have to do
next
is...
time.
Next time? You promise?
Promise.
Hot damn. Okay. Okay, got a deal. Bye, Bobby.
Well, young man, this has been quite a long visit, hasn't it?
Yeah, I was just going. Bye, Bobby.
We mustn't tire our boy out, must we? Did you talk to your grandson today? No? Oh, that's a shame, and he came all this way. Well, I may have to talk to your doctor about stronger pills. There you go. Oh, isn't this a smart cap? Well, I'll just put this over here, since you won't really be needing it, will you?
Kill me.
She would?
Uh-huh.
Really?
Uh-huh.
I guess you missed the bus.
So how did...
What was that?
Oh. Never mind. So how did you get to drive? You got a license?
Sure. Anyone can get a license. Driving's easy. Wanna learn?
No. I already know how.
You do?
Uh-huh.
How?
My dad taught me. Okay. Well... He didn't really taught me, but I watched him a lot, and then I practiced in the garage.
You want to try for real?
God damn. Happy New Year.
I missed the bus.
You know how worried I was when that bus came and you weren't on it?
I'm sorry.
No, you're not allowed to ride around in cars with strangers.
I'm sorry. I reached not a stranger, I reached my friend.
And I certainly don't think you should be riding alone in a car with a girl.
I'm sorry.
Now promise me you won't do that again.
I promise.
I don't know about that school. Maybe your father is right. You didn't used to do things like that.
Sorry.
Rachel. Lies, Rachel. Lies.
I'm back, Bobby.
Why did you leave? Why? Where the hell have you been?
Well, I've been at home.
Liar. Never. Never forgive you. Never forgive you. You come. You go. You stay. Or go.
Bobby.
No good. I hate you.
Bobby. You hate me?
Rachel. Nana Rachel.
I'll take you for a walk.
Oh.
Yeah.
No,
walk. No. I mean, I'll wheel you outside.
Too tired.
No, come on, Bobby. Yeah. You promised. Okay.
Next time.
No, Bobby, you promised this time, don't you lie.
Too weak.
No.
Too dangerous.
No, I won't let you fall. Don't you trust me? Hot damn. Okay.
Wait.
What?
Glasses. What? In the drawer.
Oh, okay. Ew. What's this?
Oh,
okay, here. Put it on.
No. That was another day.
Oh. Okay. Hey, here we go.
Nolie.
Yeah.
Golf cap.
Oh. Here we go. Ready? Nice and easy. All right. Okay, I'm just gonna get the door. Okay. Here we go. Wait a minute. Here we go. All right, okay.
Uh-oh. Your door. Okay. Better just push it. Okay? Oh.
It was a hell of a lot easier before you came.
Sorry, Bobby.
Stop calling me that stupid name, Bobby. Name is Ross. Call me Papa Ross. Your name is Noel.
I know. Only I don't care.
Suit yourself.
Okay. Breathe. Deep breaths.
I said it was easier before you came, not better.
Okay. All right now. I've been thinking about your exercises. I have two very special ones to start out with, all right? The first one, okay? You put your arms way up in the air, and then you go down like that, all right? Okay, you gotta do it too. Put your arms way up, and then you go down. Up.
Yeah,
that's right. Down, then up.
You woke me up from a long sleep, an easy sleep. And this week, the longest I can remember, terribly long until Rachel came.
Poppy, Pop Ross?
And I started to sleep again. Used to spend weeks with Rachel. Remember Rachel?
Oh, Rachel.
Rachel.
Rachel. Nana Rachel.
Died and left me.
Oh, okay.
I was gonna die first. I'd be left alone.
Oh no, it's not very nice.
What the hell do you know? Mr. Wise Guy, Mr. Smart Guy. Maybe it was better before you came. Take me back.
But we didn't do exercise.
I'm tired.
No, we didn't do exercise.
Take me back.
No, you promised. All right, now. Okay, you don't like that one, we'll do the other one, all right? So the arms too, okay? Gotta put it in the air, okay? Now I'm gonna leave them there. What are you doing? What are you doing? Bobby? You promised.
Hi, son. How was my dad? Hey, you want a beer? Hey, Nolie. Pick up your bike.
Nolie, what's wrong?
Well, so much for your theories about getting back on a horse and riding right away.
What do you want? Smiles and giggles all the time?
I don't want anything. I just don't like to see him upset, that's all.
Always upset. People get upset. You get upset. You're upset now, aren't you?
Damn it, I'm not upset. Why do you keep twisting things? I just don't see why you let him go there if it's going to make him unhappy.
He's your son, too. Why'd you let him go?
Because it's your father.
Oh, no, that's not my father.
It is your
father.
That's
not my father. My God, my father was a man. He was alive and strong and stubborn. He could hold me or whip me. That body in a wheelchair, that's not my father. If I ever get like that, I hope somebody takes a gun and shoots me.
Oh,
puts
Frank.
Me out of my misery.
Oh, Frank.
So Nolie likes to see him. Great. At least somebody goes to see him. God knows I can't. First, I got a son that can't grow up to be a man. Then I got a father that is as helpless as a baby. What the hell is going on, Doc?
Shake a lot in the morning, he's cleaner. Is he doing training to be a janitor or something? I tell you, Doc, Friday I'm taking a day off. Going to that two-bit school of his. I just about had it. Nolie! It's 3 o'clock in the morning. No time to be cleaning the damn cellar. Crying out loud. Come on, put the broom down and go to bed. Come on.
I couldn't sleep.
Well, great. Now I can't either. I just have a comic book to read or something. Come on.
Hi, Bobby.
I mean Papa Ross.
Still not talking to me today?
Okay.
Promised me you'd do your exercises. You never used to break promises to me, you know.
I got something back here for you.
Thank you.
Mr. Wise Guy. Ah, son of a bitch. Chip shot, Nolie. Chip shot. Wedge. Driver, Mr. Wise Guy.
I almost got a licking on account of you.
Get me a ball.
Right.
Move those damn things, will you?
Oh. Okay. Hit it. Hit it.
Can't do it. Can't do it. Get me out of here. Help me out of here.
Are you sure?
No.
Okay. Okay, hold on, wait a minute. Okay. Come on. Come on.
No. Can't do it. Been too long. Felt great, though. Damn you, Nolie. I'm gonna play a game of golf before I croak.
Okay! All right.
Look at that stance.
What?
Open it up.
All right.
Open it up. Open it up. Hold your hands together.
All right.
All right. Now hit the ball.
Oh, I'm gonna hit it.
Hit it.
I'm gonna kill it.
Go.
Look out, ball.
Wow!
You sliced it, Mr. Smart Guy.
Oh, God!
Daylight savings time. We got afternoons now, too.
Thank you.
Me neither.
It is boring.
So I think this is an exception.
Whoa, slow down, killer. We want to talk to you.
Come here.
No, I gotta go.
Just listen to us. Larry and I just wanted to say how pleased we are with your progress.
Yeah.
You've gone from 35 to 55% productivity, Noel.
Oh, yeah.
70% is almost workers put out in the competitive world.
Oh, yeah, I gotta go.
Yeah, you might set a record here for fastest trained client.
I gotta go.
Okay, hey, are you watching your money management? That's a weak spot for you.
Hey.
What?
Oh. I thought we were gonna be friends. But you never hang around to talk to me anymore.
I'm sorry. I gotta go.
What do you run off to every afternoon?
You know, my grandfather's.
Yeah, well, what do you do if you can't talk or hear or move?
Nothing. Okay. Tell stories, talk to him. He's my special project.
Hey, Noel, wanna drive home today? I got the car.
Okay.
How come?
You know, I promised. I promised my mom I wouldn't ride with you.
Oh, no, don't be so dumb. People break promises every day. You told me she had a meeting somewhere. And your dad. How would they know?
Papa Ross. Look. I brought my friend Irene to see you. Irene.
You caught him, Bobby.
Huh? Yeah. Well, I used to, but I think he likes Papa Ross better. Papa Ross, it's okay. Irene is my best friend. I eat lunch with her. I tell her all my secrets. Almost.
Hello, Mr. Ross.
No, his name's Mr. Miner. Papa Ross, that's his first name.
Hello, it's nice to meet you.
Come on, Bob Ross. Irene's my friend, too. Bob Ross.
Come on, Nolie, maybe we better go.
Okay. You can tell her.
Come on, Nolie, let's go.
Bob Ross, you can tell her.
Come on, Nolie.
Nice to see you again, Mrs. Miner.
Thank you.
This must be your husband?
Yes, Frank, this is Mr. Hahn.
Ted Hahn. Pleased to meet you. Please, let's sit down. Well, as I understand it, you are considering removing Noel from the program?
Yes, that's right. That is, Mr. Miner wants.
May I inquire as to the reason? We were just telling Noel how
name is Nolie.
Yes, I understand. However, Nolie is the diminutive version of Noel. We use every chance we get to treat and refer to our clients as adults.
I've been calling him Nolie all his damn life. He never complained.
Why do you wish to pull your son from the program, Mr. Miner?
He's 21 years old. I think it's high time he get on his own, earn some real money and a real job.
Well, that's not necessarily incompatible with our aims. Actually, we encourage independent living arrangements by our clients. In fact, right now, Noel, your son, is in a class learning apartment living. Surely he must have talked about it.
Well, that's all right. I didn't know. It's his mother's doing.
Oh, well, you give him social training and time-telling classes and things like that. Isn't that right? Well, he doesn't have to leave home now when he's older, maybe.
Actually, Mrs. Miner, it was our feeling that in a few more months, Noel would probably be ready for the move.
Well, he's just like a child. You know how he is.
He's progressing very rapidly. You must have noticed a difference. We were going to discuss this with you at our 6-week conference next month.
You're not taking Nolie out of my house. He's still my child.
Mrs. Miner, please try to understand. Noel's not being forced to do anything. The key here is encouragement.
I think I understand just perfectly, Mr. Hahn. Perhaps Mr. Miner is right. After all, this may not be the right place for Nolie. Frank?
Oh, sit down, Dottie.
No, I think I've heard all I want to hear. I really want to go.
I'd like to hear some more. I think that's good. You're teaching him to live out of the house. I think that's good. I'm all for it.
It's just great, isn't it, Frank? Now you're the real understanding parent. Mr. Hahn, would you like to know why he wants Nolie out of the house? He wants Nolie out of the house because Nolie is an embarrassment to him. Because after all those years of trying to have a child and then giving up, he finally ends up with Nolie. Well, that was just terrific, wasn't it? Sorry you had to be subjected to that. I just don't know.
Mrs. Miner, we all carry reasons for our attitudes toward our children. What we must try to do is to keep those attitudes from becoming destructive, either to our children or to our families. Please, leave Noel in the program while you and your husband work this out.
I'm afraid that won't be possible, Mr. Hahn. Thank you.
Surely.
You never wanted children from me, and you know it. You never wanted me or Nolie.
I never wanted Nolie. Oh, smart, Frank. Very smart. I'm the one who spent all my time with Nolie.
Yeah, you got that right. All of it. All of it.
Listen, Frank, I want
to... No, listen to me. We had problems before. Who doesn't? Then Nolie becomes a problem. Then you latch onto him like a damn shield to keep me away from you, right? That's why I wanted him out of the house. That's why you still don't.
Maybe Nolie and I should both get out of the house.
Papa Ross, brought you a plant.
Finally. Come over and do this. Clear out this tubing. Damn pills will spill on the floor, and that'll be it. Oh, God, it happened. Hurry up. Pick these up before somebody comes in the room. Put the plant on the chair.
What?
Right there. Right there on the chair. And get that card. Get what? That card. On the television set. That's it. Now, pick up these pills.
Oh.
Good. Good. Feel like a million.
Papa Ross, are you mad at me about yesterday?
She's cute.
I'm sorry.
Look at me when you speak. Don't look down for anyone. And don't apologize for everything. Nobody else does. You do what you have to do.
Kill time.
Hurry up, get rid of these.
The toilet. I think I broke it. Oh, someone's gonna see this. Oh, no. I'm gonna do it with my hand. Ew. Oh, yuck.
Mr. Miner, there you go.
I'm getting it out. I'm cleaning it out. Don't worry. There's only a little bit more. Oh.
Oh, yuck. Okay. That's the last of it. I just gotta clean up. Boy, is this gross.
Certainly is gross, young man. I suggest you keep the door shut when you use the bathroom.
Buddy management, and time telling, and bus riding and directions. That's how I know how to get here. Directions. And cooking. I don't want to cook. And living alone in apartments. They want us to live alone in apartments. Like Barry Duncan, Dave Davies.
And you?
Oh, no. Mom would never let me. She thinks it would be too hard for me. Thinks I'd get in trouble or something.
Your dad, he doesn't agree, does he?
How did you know?
I know.
Yeah, well, he wants me out. He thinks I'm too old to be living at home.
So what? You are too old to live at home. We both are.
Going home to your parents at our age is ridiculous. Think about it, Dottie.
That's just what I want, Frank. I want some time to think about it.
I know where you're going.
I just want some time.
Nolie. What about Nolie?
What?
Nolie!
Well, he's going with me.
Aw.
You were wrong, Frank. I never used him like a shield.
What? Is that why you're going, just to prove that I was wrong again? Is that it? All right, I'll admit I was wrong, but don't drag him into it.
I'm taking him because I'm his mother, and I love him, and he needs me.
He doesn't need you. Not anymore, Dottie. He needs a workshop.
Oh, the workshop? Oh, that cobbling school that you wanted him out of? With all of those friends who don't act like grown-ups? Well, don't worry, Frank. Don't worry. There are other workshops and other friends. Anyway, you'll finally have him out of the house.
That's not what I meant by out of the house, and you know it. You're twisting it.
It's a direct quote.
Hey, Dottie, let him go. You've smothered him for 21 years. You've got more of a child than a man.
You said it, Frank. You said it all. What do you want me to do? Leave him here with you? How often have you spent any time with him? How many times have you played ball with him or taken him to a movie or any place? You never did any of the things a father does with a son, and that's why he doesn't know how to act like a man.
All right, you take him. He's all you got. But one day he's going to stand up and demand to live a life of his own, and when he does, you're going to have to learn to live yours.
Bye, Nolie.
Bye, Nolie.
Bye,
Nolie.
Bye, Nolie.
Bye, Nolie.
You're tough, Nolie.
Bye, Nolie.
Take good care of yourself, then, Nolie.
Bye. Bye, Nolie.
Bye, Nolie. I'll miss you.
Nolie, there you are. Sad day, huh? Well, goodbyes are always sad. Just part of growing up. But you'll have a good time tomorrow. Traveling's fun. It's always fun. And you're gonna like Indiana. Remember when you went to see Grandma Helen?
I want to say goodbye to Papa Ross.
Bobby?
Papa Ross.
Well, I guess that can be arranged. I'd like to say goodbye to him, too. We could stop by there on the way tomorrow.
Now.
Come on, darling.
Car's back. There's Nolie.
Sleeping? Why?
I'll say goodbye to my son. Of deep feelings. No. I won't be here tomorrow morning when you leave. I'm not too good at saying goodbye either. But I want you to know that I understand.
You and Bobby fight because of me?
No, that's not true.
Yeah, you told me never a lie. I heard you fighting a lot.
Well, sometimes people get married and find out they can't get along too good. So they argue and fight about things they shouldn't. But we both love you.
Well, why do I have to leave? Don't you love me as much as Bobby does?
I do every bit. Just that's the way things are sometimes. I want you to know that this past year, I wanted you out of the house, but not out of my life. I wanted you out of the house because you're a man. You're a man, Nolie. Remember that. You're not a child. Goodbye.
Doing?
There's no school today.
It's not school. It's called workshop.
No, honey. We're going to Indiana today. Don't you remember?
I want to go to work today.
Nolie, don't be ridiculous. We've had these plans for a long time. Don't you remember? I don't understand. You feel okay?
I want to go to the workshop.
Oh, Nolie, I'm sorry. Would you like to go and see Bobby one more time? It's right on the way. Would you like to go see Bobby? Don't be fresh, Nolie. Nolie, I feel as bad as you do. But the workshop wasn't right for you. Daddy agrees with me.
Don't be fresh, Nolie. Stop what they're doing. My name is Noah. You call me Noah. I am not a baby. I am not a kid. I am Noah.
Nolie!
Bob Ross. We're gonna play golf.
What is this?
Get in.
I'm not getting in.
Get in.
I'm not gonna get in.
Get in. I said we're gonna play golf.
Could drive.
I can't. I mean, this is my first time alone. I told you, Irene taught me.
What? Are you kidding me?
No.
Well, slow down at least. If we crash, maybe we'll live.
Oh, all right. My foot. Right.
What's wrong, Nolie?
Noah. You call me Noah. I'm not leaving. Not you, not the workshop.
Don't leave me, Noah.
Oh, I won't. But you left me, you and Nana Rachel.
She was sick. The winters were too hot on her.
But you stayed after she died.
It was easier. Old people want things easy. That's their mistake. Like playing dead in a nursing home. It only kills you sooner. Don't leave.
I'm not.
Hello. Irene who?
Hello? Yes? Of course I do. Yes. No, we haven't either. Yes, thank you. We'd be very nice if you could call if you hear anything. Goodbye. It's a friend of his. She hasn't heard anything either.
Oh, I can't hang around here anymore. I'm gonna go look for him.
Where are you going?
I don't know.
Frank, wait, please. I need you here.
Noel.
What?
Pull over.
What?
Here.
What?
Now.
What's the matter?
I don't think there's a golf course around here.
What?
And I don't think I can really play golf anyway. Can't swing the club hard enough. Can't walk all that way. It's no good.
No, but you promised. And you said you wanted to play golf one more time.
Look, Noel, people say things they shouldn't. Make promises and can't keep them. It happens all the time. Promises mean everything to a child, but you're not a child anymore. Forget about promises. I'm sorry. That's life. And I'm an old man. Too old for golf.
Hey, mister, can you give me my ball? My ball.
Come on, come on, come on.
win one. Bonnerman, I get a free game. Free game, Pavarov. I get a free game.
Ingrate.
What's that?
You beat me. You're ungrateful.
I brought you. I paid.
So you did.
Hold it, one.
You did it. Oh, dear.
Here you go, kid. Use it anytime.
Thank you.
Look at this. Why not?
Because.
Because why?
Because they don't want anybody like me.
Who are you?
Papa Ross. This is a competitive world. That's what they tell you at the workshop, that this is a competitive world.
What's so competitive about a par 9 minutes of golf course? Think you have to be Einstein to work here? Or to survive in a competitive world? You think that guy was Einstein?
Einstein? Hey, do you want to see what a workshop is?
Sure.
There it is. There it is.
I don't know. How the hell do you get here?
Bus. Why? What's wrong?
This part of town is a dump.
Yeah. Well, Barry says they like to keep us out of sight. Everybody's gone home. It's not too nice, huh?
It's all right, Noah. It's all right.
Well, it's the inside that count, right? Anyway, I like it.
Good.
Really?
I'm hungry.
You want to get some to eat?
Pull up around the corner.
Why? What's the matter?
Pull up around the corner.
All right.
Right around the inside.
Here, okay. What's the matter?
No.
What?
I missed your 21st birthday.
Oh.
I couldn't get you a gift. But now I'm going to make it up to you. Just like I did for Frank, only he was younger, 16.
You gonna give me a birthday gift?
I'll need some money. How much money you got?
Oh, okay. All right. $12. Let me see. 51 cents. And a free golf game. Huh. You know them?
Don't I wish? No.
What?
You know who those ladies are?
No.
The prostitutes. Who is?
Boys.
Who is?
Boys?
Boys.
Boys? Well, Barry told me about them.
Einstein, so you do know.
Yeah. Barbara, they're coming. They're coming here.
Roll down the window.
Let's see.
Oh. Nolie, roll down the window.
Hey, young fellas, can we help you find what you're looking for? I'm Angel.
This is my grandson, Nolie.
Nolie,
this is my grandson, Nolie. He just turned 21. And the only thing wrong with him is he needs some education.
Looks like you can use a refresher course yourself, young man.
I'd sure like that. But right now, all we've got is $12.51.
Are you kidding?
That's all we got.
Sorry, Gramps. Tuition's gone up a whole lot since you went to school, and we don't give no scholarships. So why don't you guys go scratch up some real dough and come back some other time, okay? School's always open.
Oh, God,
let's go get something to eat.
Okay.
Oh, God.
No. I'm stumped.
You're drunk.
No, I was thirsty. Now I'm stumped.
Don't talk back to me, Einstein. You can't be stuffed. You didn't eat much.
That's because I'm taking care of myself. Gonna get myself in good shape, like Mr. Phelps said. Oh, boy. He was right about you.
So he was. So he was.
Okay, Papa Ross?
I'm tired now.
Well, guess I better get you back.
Back?
Yep.
Not back there to that sleep.
Yeah? Well, where? Oh, boy, I'm really gonna catch it. And we can't stay away forever, you know.
No, I'll pay the bill.
Oh.
Just go up and give it whatever it says under the line.
Oh, under the line?
Under the line.
All right. Under the line?
Yeah.
It says 10-6-3.
Give her that.
All right. I got a hole in what?
Bob Ross? Bob Ross? I can't find the body. I can't find the body. What do we do?
What do we do? Check your pockets again.
No, oh, I am. Wait, I don't got the money.
Did you have it in the car?
What? In the car? Yeah. I don't know. Well, yeah, I had it in the car.
Let's not panic. We'll figure out something. Go check the car.
Why? The car?
The seat maybe fell out.
Oh, right. All right. Yeah. Bob Ross, what are you doing? We gotta go.
Hey, is he okay?
What? No. Yes, I don't know.
Do you want me to call an ambulance?
No.
You better get him out of here. We're cleaning up.
Oh, Bobby, we gotta go. Please.
Oh, Bobby, we gotta go, please.
Are you sure he's okay?
What? Yeah, he's all right. Okay. I don't know.
Bob, he ain't moving.
Help
it's
me.
Okay.
Help me.
And he walked in here.
Charlie, come on.
Come on, nothing. This guy's having a coronary attack.
No.
I've seen it on TV. I've seen it on the news.
Come on.
I'm going to call the cops.
No, don't do that. Come on. No.
I'm calling the cops!
Oh, you liar!
Einstein, we saved our hides, like teamwork.
Oh, yeah?
And I was also making a point.
What's that? Nolie's retarded?
But I don't want to go back to that home. Sleep is the only thing left for me there.
And stop calling me Einstein. That's a stupid name, Einstein. Who the heck's Einstein, anyway?
Einstein?
Yeah.
Einstein was a very smart man. And a gentleman.
Yeah, so why did you call me that? I'm not so smart. And I'm not a gentleman.
No?
No.
You were the only person smart enough to see what was needed to make me live. Or you used to be. And the only person gentle enough to find the time and patience to do it.
So what do you want to do? You want to go home with me? Ha!
I want an apartment and a roommate. You. Clara, before I drool on you. On with Christian soldiers marching at the fall.
Just where do you think you were going?
Where do we think we're going?
We're going to my house.
No, after that. Tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. We're going out into the competitive world.
I'm calling your parents.
Tell them we're on our way. Hot damn. I think we'll be okay, Noah. I think we'll be okay.
You know, Papa Ross, I've been thinking. You can call me Einstein if you want.
Okay, Einstein.
Okay.
Here we go. Gotta hurry now. We're free to win this world. Be in this world, my friend and me. Not a game. Got a lot of things to mend. When we go in this world, me and my friend. If the moon is kinda low, we lift it up and make it land. It's not too old to change. This planet's in its prime. It just forgets to turn. Not to worry now, we're free to brave this world, to save this world, my friend and me. Not a game, got a lot of dreams to tend. When we go in this